Good morning, Brisas Geckos. Good morning, Mrs. Winkleman.
Good morning, Miss Attili. Welcome back to school.
Yes, thank you. Today is Tuesday, August 25th, 2020, and I have a great picture of a dream team to share with you. First thing, Mrs. Winkleman, look at this.
Oh, it's virtually our fifth grade. They do rock. Look at their personalities. Love their matching shirts. They are the best. That's
they
awesome.
Are the best. That's great. And what school spirit? We love matching shirts around here. We know how that is.
Yes, we do.
All right. We have a few more nice shares from today. This is Miss Fry's kindergartner, Kaylee. And she had this share that Miss Fry was really proud of her for and wanted to make sure everyone got to see it. So this was work where they were talking about being respectful, responsible, and safe and coming up with examples of that. And Kaylee's example was to not stand on a table. That little drawing of someone standing on a table, that would not be safe. We always keep our feet on the floor. So thank you, Kaylee, for that. Great job. And then this is also Ms. Fry's student. This is Mateo, and he did some great work with a matching activity, and Ms. Fry was so proud of him for that. So great job, Mateo. And this one is an example of a thinking map. This is what we're asking for this week to brisasnews@kyrene.org. So if you have any examples of circle maps, or this week we're working on bubble maps, you can send any of those to brisasnews@kyrene.org, and we would love to show your thinking maps. So this one is a circle map, and it was from Zoe Ruiz. She is a fourth grader, and this is a circle map about how you can have a great year in fourth grade. What an awesome topic to do a circle map about. So Zoe, we're sure you're going to have a great year, and you have some great ideas there in your circle map for how to do that. So thank you so much for sharing that.
All right, well, let's start with a couple of reminders. I just want to start off by thanking all of our parents and staff that came to our PTSO meeting last night, a virtual meeting on Zoom at 6 o'clock. It was great to see everyone, and we had some terrific brainstorming about how to make sure the school year in this virtual reality remains fun and engaging for everybody. So thank you for participating. And if you did not come last night, but you think that that might be something that you want to do in the future, please stay tuned, because we will be meeting every single month, and we would love to have everyone there. One of the things that we discussed at that meeting, though, was Bahama Bucks, and that's our first community builder. We had it on our calendar originally for this coming Friday, but we're going to move it to Monday, the 31st. And so families, if you would like to go to Bahama Bucks on Monday, a portion of the proceeds will be donated right back to Brisas, and you may see some Brisas families there as well. So hope that you enjoy that and look at all those wonderful treats. I'd like to have one right now, honestly.
Yes, they look delicious.
They do look delicious. Another couple reminders. Yesterday, we sent out some emails to our kindergarten and first grade parents regarding some options for learning. So if you're feeling like your student is just spending a lot of time in the front of the computer with our virtual learning, no worries. We've got some different options for you. So please look for that email, and please feel free to make some good decisions that are in the best interest of your son or daughter, and that know that you have our support here at school as well. So always feel free to reach out to your teacher if you've got questions. All right. And then, okay, so then there was Dibbles, right? So we did start Dibbles, and yesterday we were so excited. And some of our students did give it a shot, but with Zoom, we had some challenges. And so we're just going to start over again today. So the following classrooms are scheduled to do their Dibbles testing today, and we know you're going to do a great job. In second grade, we've got students from Ms. Pelletier's class and from Ms. Foster's class. And then in third grade, Ms. Berger's students are going to be doing Dibbles. And then in fourth grade, Ms. Hebert, and in fifth grade, Ms. Almendares' students. So do your very best. Moms and dads, please know this is an assessment, and we want to know kind of where their skill set is right now so that we can plan our instruction and interventions accordingly. So let them do their best, and we will move from there. So thanks so much.
Okay, I think it is our best time of announcements, Mrs. Winkleman. Are you ready to talk about peace?
I am always ready to talk about peace, because it's so important that we are being respectful, responsible, and safe, whether we are at home or we are at school. So, Ms. Attili, you are always so in tune with what our parents and our teachers are thinking in terms of peaceful behaviors. And I'm sure you've checked Facebook and Instagram, right? All right. Well, so based on what everyone is saying, was yesterday, Monday, a peaceful day at Brisas?
Well, after our PTSO meeting last night, I got on and checked Instagram and Facebook to see how those votes looked. And even with some Zoom issues yesterday, you guys persevered, you made it a great day, and it was a peaceful day. So awesome job. That makes for 6 days of peace. We had a full week of peace last week, and we are starting this week off great too with another day of peace. So 6 days of peace, counting up to 15 days of peace, when we will have our first Peace Day celebration. So I'm really looking forward to that.
Yes, so are we. All right, well, fantastic. Then let's go ahead and start our wonderful day of learning here at Bresis. If I can have you please stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance.
And let's have a peaceful day.
Bye,
Bresis Geckos.